ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్
రిఫ్లెక్స్ యాక్షన్ అండ్ రిఫ్లెక్స్ ఆర్క్ దెన్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది reflex action. What is the definition of the reflex action? Means automatically involuntarily instantaneously suddenly whatever the actions which may be occurs in our body to protect from the effect of the dangerous, such kind of the actions are said to be as the reflex action or reflexive action. Reflex action means automatically, means without our conscious, whatever the reaction, whatever the actions which may be gets appears, which may be evoke against to the dangerous to protect our body, that kind of the action is said to be as the reflex action. Automatically, involuntarily, without our conscious, instantaneously, suddenly, whatever the reactions which may be occurs in our body without our conscious, that kind of the action is said to be as the reflex action. So definitely the reflex action, to evoke the reflex action, through which route nerve information gets conducted, that route is said to be as the reflex arc. Through which route nerve information gets conducted to evoke this reflex action, that route is said to be as the reflex arc. In the reflex arc, when we observe the reflex arc route, at first receptor receive the information from the external environment, later from the receptor information reaches to the efferent neuron. This is also called as sensory neuron. From that kind of the efferent neuron or sensory neuron, information reaches to the interneuron or spinal cord, where that information gets analyzed. Again, motor information is generated in interneuron of spinal cord. From where that motor information reaches to the efferent neuron, this is also called as the motor neuron. That is said to be as the motor neuron. Again, from the efferent neuron or motor neuron, that reaches to the effectors or to the muscle or to the glands. Effectors are nothing but either the muscles or the glands. So in that way, definitely this information is at first collected by the receptor, later that will be processed to the efferent neuron or sensory neuron. later from the efferent neuron that will be conducted to the interneuron of spinal cord, where that information is gets analyzed against to that motor information is gets generated. This motor information later reaches to efferent neuron or motor neuron, from where that will be reaches to the effector or to the muscle or to the gland to finally evoke the response against to the dangerous condition to protect our body from the effect of dangerous. This is said to be as the reflex arc. Such kind of the sudden responses, such kind of the sudden actions which may be evoked in our body to protect our body from the effect of the dangerous, that kind of the action is said to be as the reflex action. That route through which this nerve information is gets conducted to finally evoke the response, that route is said to be as the reflex arc. For example, if our hand is touches to the hot object, if our hand is touches to the hot object, receptor which is present in the hand immediately passes the message to the sensory neuron, from where that is reaches to the spinal cord. In spinal cord that is analyzed. According to that, motor information is gets generated in spinal cord. That motor information is later conducted to motor neuron, from where that is reaches to the muscle of hand. By that way, that muscle starts contraction. By that way, we may withdraw our hand from the effect of the hot object. In that way, definitely reflex actions are occurs within fraction of seconds without our conscious to protect our body from the effect of the dangerous. So definitely the best example which is given in our syllabus to betterly explain the reflex action and the reflex arc is the knee jerk reflex. Knee jerk reflex is a better example for the reflex action. What is the knee jerk means? Just assume this is the leg of the person. This is the leg of the person. In the leg of the person, whatever the receptor which is present, that is said to be as the muscle spindle. This is the receptor. Muscle spindle is a receptor which is present in the leg of the person. Definitely from this muscle spindle, information is conducted to sensory neuron that is said to be as the efferent neuron that is said to be as the sensory neuron. Definitely muscle spindle which is present in the leg of the person that receive the information against to the external environment. Again that information is conducted to the efferent neuron or sensory neuron. This efferent neuron finally terminated with interneuron. Interneuron which is present in the spinal cord. This is the spinal cord. So whenever that information is reaches to the interneuron, in interneuron that information is gets processed or analyzed Later, according to this information, interneuron generate motor information. Later, this motor information is conducted to the motor neuron. This is said to be as the efferent. This is the efferent neuron or motor neuron. Definitely motor information which is synthesized by interneuron is reaches to the efferent neuron or motor neuron. This motor neuron finally terminated near to motor end plate. This is said to be as the motor end plate. That is nothing but neuromuscular junction. Definitely motor end plate, this is said to be as the effector. Motor end plate is said to be as the effector, means this is nothing but motor end plate, nothing but sarcocytes. This efferent motor neuron is terminated on the several sarcocytes. That unit is said to be as the motor end plate, that is the effector. In response to that, this muscle is gets contracted. By that way, person may be moves his leg away from that kind of the foreign particle or away from the pointed object. Means whenever the person's leg is touches to the foreign particle, touches to the fine object, immediately that information is recognized by the muscle spindle. Immediately that is reaches to the efferent neuron, from where that is reaches to the interneuron. In interneuron that is analyzed. According to that interneuron synthesized motor information. This motor information is later conducted to the motor neuron, from where that is reaches to the motor end plate. As a result of this, muscle cells which are present in this particular part of the leg are contracted. By that way, muscle or leg is gets moved away from that kind of the foreign object or the pointed object. In that way, if this kind of the leg shows the involuntary movement, all of a sudden to protect from the effect of the foreign object or the pointed object, then that is said to be as the knee-jerk reflex. Here very important objective questions are nothing but very, very important NEET examination questions which may be asked on this particular concept are: how many number of the neurons at least involved in the reflex arc means two. At least how many number of the neurons are gets involved in the reflex arc means two. One is the efferent neuron, second one is the efferent neuron. Second, what is the receptor in the knee-jerk reflex? Muscle spindle is the receptor. What is the effector in the knee-jerk reflex means motor end plate. Is the effector, muscle spindle is nothing but the receptor. Again, next one is the sensory information and processing. Next continuation is the sensory information and processing. Then what is the sensory information collection and processing means? Definitely receptors which are present in our body, that receptors continuously receive information from the external environment. That information later conducted to the sensory neuron. Through the sensory neuron, that is conducted to the central nervous system, either to the brain or to the spinal cord. According to this sensory information in central nervous system, motor information is gets generated. That motor information again conducted to the motor neuron. From the motor neuron, that is finally reaches to the effectors. By that way, response is gets evoked in the person. That is said to be as the sensory information and processing. Means what I am saying here, that always receptors which are present in the various parts of the body receive the sensory information from the environment continuously. Later they passes that message to the sensory neuron. Through the sensory neuron, that is finally connected to the CNS, central nervous system, that may be brain or that may be spinal cord. Later in central nervous system, motor information is gets generated. That motor information is reaches to the motor neuron. Later through the motor neuron, that will be connected to the motor organs, that may be muscle, that may be glands. Definitely these are nothing but effectors. Motor organs are nothing but effectors. In that way, definitely receptors which are present in our body, they continuously receive, they continuously detect changes which may be appears in the environment. That information immediately receive and conduct it to the sensory neuron. Through that kind of the sensory neurons, that will be conducted to the central nervous system, where that is gets analyzed. According to that information in the central nervous system, motor information is gets generated. That will be reaches to the motor neuron. Through the motor neuron, finally that will be reaches to motor organ such as the muscles and gland. By that way, muscles may be gets contracted to evoke the response finally, or glands may be involved in the secretion to finally evoke the response. This is said to be as the sensory information and processing. Next one is the receptors. Definitely in our body, what kind of the receptors are present? What kind of the receptors are present means, what is the receptor? Terminal part of the sensory neuron, which is able to receive external information. The terminal part of the sensory neuron is said to be as the receptor. That is the nerve ending which is able to receive the external environmental changes. That kind of the nerve ending is said to be as the receptor. Definitely receptors are of various types. What are the various types of the receptors means? One is the exteroreceptors.
Second one is the interoceptors. Third one is the proprioceptors. Fourth one is the thermoreceptors. Definitely this receptors principally categorized into four types. One is said to be as the exteroreceptor, second one is the interoceptor, third one is the proprioceptor, fourth one is the thermoreceptor. Exteroreceptors means receptors which are present on the surface of the body or near to the surface of the body, then they are said to be as the exteroreceptor. For example, photoreceptors which are present in the eye. Definitely in the case of the eye of the person, photoreceptors are present. Second one is the gustatory receptors. Gustatory receptors which are present on the tongue. What is the gustatory receptor? Receptor which is able to detect taste of the food material, that kind of the receptor is said to be as the gustatory receptor. Receptor which is able to detect the taste of the food material, they are in the skin, or better example for the exteroreceptor. These are related to pressure. They are useful to detect the pressure. These are related to pain. Definitely nocive receptors are related to pain. Passimian receptors are related to pressure. Similarly, auditory receptors which are present in ears, also better example for the exteroreceptor. Receptors which are principally present in the sense organ, such as the eye, tongue, nose, skin, ears, they are better example for the exteroreceptor. Definitely photoreceptors are useful for the vision. Gustatory receptors are useful for the taste of the food material. Olfactory receptors are useful for the sense of the smell. Passimian receptors are useful for the pressure detection. Nocive receptors principally useful to detect the pain. Auditory receptors principally useful for the listening of sound. They useful for the listening of the sound. Again, interoceptors. Receptors which are present in the visceral organ. Receptors which are present inside of the visceral organ. That receptors are said to be as the interoceptors. Better example is receptor of heart. Receptors of blood vessel. Like that way, definitely in the case of the internal organs wall, whatever the receptor which is present, that is said to be as the interoceptor. Receptor which is present in the visceral organ, that is said to be as the interoceptor. Next, proprioceptors. Receptor which is useful to maintain body balance, which may be useful to maintain the erect position of the body, that kind of the receptor is said to be as the proprioceptor. Receptors principally which may be useful to maintain erect position of the body, which may be continuously monitor the position of the body of an individual, that kind of the receptor is said to be as the proprioceptors. These are present in the muscle. They are present on the or in the tendons. They are present in the joints. They are present in internal ears. Definitely proprioceptors are present in the muscle, in the tendon, in joint, in internal ear. These principally useful to maintain the body balance. This principally useful to maintain the body position as erect. This principally useful to maintain the equilibrium of body. Next, thermoreceptors. Definitely thermoreceptors means they principally useful to monitor the variations in temperature. This kind of the receptors principally useful to detect variations in intensity of the temperature in environment, that is said to be as the thermoreceptor. Definitely these are of two types. One is the caloric receptor. Second one is the frigidoreceptor. Definitely thermoreceptors principally are of two types. One is said to be as the caloric receptor, second one is the frigidoreceptor. Caloric receptors means receptor which can be respond against to heat changes, receptor which can be able to respond against to changes in the heat intensity, that kind of the receptors are said to be as the caloric receptor. Receptor which can be able to respond against to the changes in cold, that kind of the receptors are said to be as the frigidoreceptor. They can respond against to heat, they can respond against to cold. In that way, this receptors are principally categorized into four types: exteroreceptor, interoreceptor, proprioreceptor, thermoreceptor. Thermoreceptors are of two types. One is the caloric receptor, they respond against to heat changes. Second one is the frigidoreceptor, they may be respond against to the cold. Again, what is the structure of olfactory receptor which is given in our NCERT? Definitely here, structure of olfactory receptor is given in our NCERT textbook in additional information. Then what is the structure of the olfactory receptor? Means olfactory receptors are present in the olfactory epithelium of nose. Olfactory epithelium. Structure of olfactory receptor. So definitely where this kind of the olfactory receptors are present means in olfactory epithelium of nose they are present. Definitely just assume in this kind of the olfactory epithelium, three types of the cells are present. This is nothing but olfactory epithelium. In the olfactory epithelium, this is said to be as the olfactory neuron. This is said to be as the olfactory neuron. This olfactory neuron extends up to the olfactory bulb. It extends up to the olfactory bulb from exterior. Definitely, this is the exterior. This is said to be as the olfactory neuron. These are the epithelial cells. These are the epithelial cell. This is said to be as the epithelial cells. This is said to be as the olfactory bulb. This is the olfactory bulb. This is the limbic system. Definitely, this is the limbic system. What are the olfactory bulb? Extensions of limbic system. Extensions of the limbic system is nothing but olfactory bulb. Whenever the limbic system or limbic lobe is extended upward, then this olfactory bulb formation is taken place. This olfactory neuron extends from exterior up to the olfactory bulb. Up to the olfactory bulb, this sensory neurons or the olfactory neurons are gets extends from exterior. Next, epithelial cells are present in the sensory epithelium in addition to olfactory neuron. In addition to them, mucus secreting glands also present in olfactory epithelium. Mucus secreting glands also present in olfactory epithelium. They are said to be as the Bowman's glands. These are said to be as the Bowman's glands. This Bowman's glands secrete the mucus. They principally secrete the mucus. In that way, in the olfactory receptor structure, olfactory receptors are present in the olfactory epithelium of nose. In this olfactory epithelium, three types of the cells are present. One is the olfactory neuron, that is extends from exterior up to the olfactory bulb of brain. Olfactory bulbs are formed due to the extensions of limbic system. In addition to that kind of the olfactory neuron, epithelial cells are present. Between the epithelial cells, whatever the glands which are present to secrete the mucus, they are said to be as the Bowman's glands. They are principally useful for secretion of the mucus. Definitely, olfactory receptors are able to detect the smell of substance whenever that chemical substance is dissolved in the mucus only. Whenever the chemical substance is dissolved in the mucus, then only this olfactory receptor is able to detect the smell of substance. Without getting dissolving of chemicals in mucus, this olfactory receptors are not able to detect the smell of the substance. Similarly, gustatory receptors which are present on the tongue, gustatory receptors which are present on the tongue also able to detect the taste of the food material whenever the chemicals are dissolved in the mucus of saliva. Definitely, whenever that kind of the chemical substances of food or gets dissolves in the mucus of the saliva, then only this gustatory receptors are able to detect the taste of the food material. Means what I am saying here, that both olfactory receptors as well as the gustatory receptors are functionally similar, because both of them also can perform their respective function whenever the chemical substances are dissolved in the mucus only. Definitely, olfactory receptor is only able to detect the smell of a substance whenever that substance is dissolved in the mucus. Similarly, gustatory receptors are able to detect the taste of the food material whenever that food chemicals are dissolved in the mucus of the saliva only. In that way, gustatory receptors as well as the olfactory receptors are functionally similar. Though they are structurally differ, they are functionally similar. This is the receptors. Next to the well organized sensory organ which are given in our syllabus are of two. Definitely, in our body, well organized sensory organs, well organized sensory organs which are given in our syllabus are of two. One is the eye, second one is the ear. Definitely, in our body, what are the well organized sensory structures which may be given in our body, means sensory organs which are present in our body, which are given in our syllabus, means one is the eye, second one is the ear. So the first one is the eye. Definitely, these are meant for sight or vision. These are principally useful for the vision or sight. For viewing of the object or sight, they may be principally useful. How many number of the eyes are present in our body? Means two. Each and every eye is hidden in eye orbit. In the case of the skull, whatever the depression which is present, that bone is said to be as the eye orbit. Here this depression is the eye orbit. Inside of the eye orbit, this one pair of the eyes are present. Definitely, in the case of the eye of the person, what are the parts which are present? What are the various kind of the parts which are present in the eye of the person? Means, in the case of the eye, two principal components are present. Two principal parts are present. One is said to be as the accessory structures. Second one is said to be as the eyeball. First one is the accessory structure, second one is the eyeball. Then what are the accessory structures? Means, one is the eyelids, eyelashes, eyebrows. Next, lacrimal glands.
next to eye muscles.
What are the accessory structures which may be associated to the eyeball in eye of the person? Means eyelid, eyelashes, eyebrows, lacrimal glands, eye muscle. Definitely this eyelid, eyelashes, eyebrows, this three type of the structures always protect. They provide the protection to eyeball from the effect of the foreign particle. Eyelids, eyelashes, eyebrows always provide the protection to the eyeball from the effect of the foreign particle. Lacrimal glands always secrete tears. In the tears of the person, what are present? NaCl, mucus, lysozyme. Enzyme is present. Lysozyme enzyme always kills bacteria, so that only that is said to be as the bactericidal enzyme. Definitely in the case of the tear of the person, NaCl is present, mucus is present, lysozyme enzyme is present. Lysozyme enzyme always kill bacteria. That is the bactericidal enzyme that always kills the bacteria. So that only that is said to be as the bactericidal enzyme, that is the lysozyme. Again, what kind of the eye muscles are present? Definitely rectus muscle, oblique muscle, ciliary muscle, iris muscles. Definitely what kind of the eye muscles are associated to eye of the person? Means rectus muscle, oblique muscle, ciliary muscle, iris muscle. Again, rectus muscles are of four types: superior rectus, inferior rectus, again lateral rectus, medial rectus. Medial rectus muscle. This oblique muscles are of two types: superior oblique, inferior oblique muscle. In that way, in the case of the eye of person, in associated to the eye, what kind of the muscles are present? Means rectus muscle, oblique muscle, ciliary muscle, iris muscle. Again, rectus muscles are of four types: superior rectus, inferior rectus, lateral rectus, medial rectus. Oblique muscles also two types: superior oblique and inferior oblique. This eye muscles are innervated with the third, fourth, sixth cranial nerves. Definitely to this kind of the eye muscle, what are the cranial nerves which may be innervated? Means third cranial nerve, fourth cranial nerve, sixth cranial nerves are gets innervated. Specifically to the superior oblique muscle, fourth cranial nerve, to the lateral rectus muscle, medial rectus muscle, sixth cranial nerve, sixth cranial nerve is gets innervated to the rest of them. Third cranial nerve is gets innervated, sorry, to the lateral rectus muscle. Sixth cranial nerve is gets innervated to the superior oblique muscle. Fourth cranial nerve is innervated to rest of all. Third cranial nerve is gets innervated. So definitely, what is the use of the eye muscle? Means eye muscles always useful to move eyeball from side to side. To move the eyeball from side to side, this kind of the eye muscles are a lot useful. So in that way, what are the accessory structures which may be associated to the eyeball of person? Eye of person means eyelid, eyelashes, eyebrows. They principally useful to provide the protection. Lacrimal glands always produces tears. The tears is with the NaCl mucus lysozyme enzyme. Lysozyme principally kill the bacteria. Eye muscles principally are of four types: rectus muscle, oblique muscle, ciliary muscle, iris muscle. Rectus muscles again are of four types: superior rectus, inferior rectus, lateral rectus, medial rectus. Oblique muscles are of two types: superior oblique and inferior oblique. In that way, all this kind of the eye muscles are innervated with third, fourth, sixth cranial nerve. This eye muscles are principally useful to move eyeball from side to side. Next to eyeball,